talked enough. You guys tired of it now, huh? I'm excited. Boom. Please welcome my very good friend, Mr. Frank Secich.
Thank you, Bill. Thanks. Thanks so much. I grew up in Sharon, PA, about an hour away from here, and I write a lot of songs about, there goes a little bit for Sharon there, about people I knew who I grew up with and stuff, and one of them was a legendary guy called Ray Robinson, who was the Green Man, you probably heard about. And I knew him when I was 16 years old, and he passed away in 1985, and was a great guy, so this is my song, The Green Man. Cousin Alvin Dabney, who was a professional thief in Akron. He goes, man, we should quit school. This is like ninth grade. We'll join up with my cousin. And I said, oh, that sounds like a trip to the penitentiary to me. He goes, oh man, he never gets caught. All this stuff, he steals diamond rings and cars and the cops can't catch my son. I don't know about that. But anyway, he would regale me with stories of his cousin Alvin. Alvin died a few years ago, and he was in New Orleans, of all places. But this is my Alvin Dabney professional thief song from the Deadbeat Poets, my current band.
I love Halloween, it's so fine, so fine. I
what she don't want. Even if she knows, she doesn't say.
STIV BATORS. He was in the Dead Boys, maybe you know him, and we did a lot, I did all his solo stuff with him. And Jimmy Zero and I from the Dead Boys wrote a song called Evil Boy. We were kind of making fun of STIV and just wanted to show it to him for a laugh, but he loved the song. So we ended up recording it, and it got recorded by a lot of other people. So here's Evil Boy. First gig ever professionally 50 years ago tonight. 1966 when I was 15. I had a little band with some of my friends called the Electrons. We played at a party in Sharon. And this is one of the songs we did. I always like pulling this one out every once in a while. I wasn't planning on doing it tonight, but I'm going to. It's the first record I ever bought at G.C. Murphy's. Remember that store? 510? In Faro, PA. And it was by Elvis. I heard it on the radio. I was 9 years old and flipped me out to no end. But Marisa, the name was Lady Slane. Circumstantial Evidence. It's the title of my book, too. I wrote a book last year, and Neil was talking about I've been traveling all over the world, doing book signings and playing acoustic things and swords and everything. And this song's called Circumstantial Evidence. It's one I wrote for STIV BATORS, and it was the second single that he did on Bomb Records, 1980. And a funny story about it is I had the whole thing done, and I wrote most of the lyrics on it. And the third verse, I didn't like it. He was ready to record it. And so I said, here's it. I wrote a new one out real quick. My girlfriend blank heard about me all alone with her best friend blank over the telephone. And gave him the lyrics. I said, just put in two girls' names there. And he looks at me and he sees Joan Jett, who was at our session, and my wife Lisa over there talking in the corner. So he said, Joan and Lisa. So that's how that came into this song. This is recorded by quite a few people. This is called Circumstantial Evidence.
Lieutenant, Lieutenant, called me to the police station while pursuing the investigation. He said, where were you last night at 10? Teach
kitchen.